Well, we are in the fields bright and early this morning. As you know, the short election was called yesterday. So our team is ready. We are hitting the road. We are ready to serve. So we are here in Venture Number 3, St. John. We are doing our morning canvas. And our activities will run throughout the day. We are going back into the field this afternoon. And then again later in the night. Because obviously, we've been out canvassing before, short election cycle, so you've got to touch as much ground as possible, hearing the concerns of the residents of St. John, encouraging them to come out and vote. And we do know that St. John people were not satisfied with the outcome of the last election. And most Barbadians too are recognizing, look, 30-0 is not for us. And we need to be in a situation where we get more seats in the House and we have at least two parties representing. And that's where the Democratic Labour Party is coming in. And that would be part of my mandate for St. John, to make sure the Democratic Labour Party reclaims this seat. So I have my team with me. You know, we want to meet the needs of St. John people. They're recognizing that they have not necessarily got their fair share of the pie in this election, and also their complaints about the representative being distant or not available or not necessarily treating them in the right way. My approach is, I am a resident of St. John to work with the people of St. John. I'm a humble person, and I understand the challenges of St. John residents, and I want to work to make sure that St. John residents get their fair share of the economic pain.
Okay, you would have said that you have been canvassing the area before. Mm-hmm. What are the areas that the residents had particular concerns in that weren't being addressed?
The concerns that weren't being addressed, well, obviously you know that we were impacted by COVID, and you have a lot of community issues, the bus networks, those sorts of things that are not being addressed, the road networks that are not being properly addressed in the area, job opportunities as well, agriculture. We have issues with agriculture in Barbados. There's a lot of land that the residents were hoping will be turned back into agriculture. The Clico lands, which are close to us, were promised since July last year, and up to now they have not received those lands to start working them up. And if you know St. John, agriculture is critical to most St. John persons in the area. So these are the things. We also, even with COVID, there's still a need for working with the school children, having after school programs where possible, because the online platform was difficult for most parents in the constituency. There wasn't any sort of consistency, and you don't want for our children to be falling behind. So opportunities to have more face-to-face teaching or training for the children, those are things that are important at this time. Well, my representation would be one where I will work with the people, listen to the people, because you need to be a representative that listens to the people. You bring what they need, you don't force your needs on them. And that comes about by listening to the residents of St. John. And St. John people have a lot of ideas in terms of business growth and development, and we just need the access to the financing to start that. Not just a $5,000 trust fund loan that you can't even get that easily, but you want more so that you can invest in the business, but also have the working capital to get it done. There are people who want to do things in terms of the soap making and barbershops or salons, those sorts of things. That is something that is needed in St. John, a recognizable salon that you can pass through the community and see that this is a barbershop here, and that anybody, we don't have to go in town to get our hair done. There are barbers operating in St. John, but they would operate from within their houses. But we need to have established barbershops, a number of different areas for business development as well. So that sort of business development we need. People are interested in agriculture. You need the money to get the land cultivated. You need the money to develop the chicken pens or to raise the pigs, those kind of things. So having easy access to that sort of finance, we find that that was not being done under this administration. The money was going to the big businesses, the $300 million that went to tourism, but not much money was going towards small business, or the average person with a business idea lost a job due to COVID but want to do something to make ends meet. Those are the people that have been neglected.
Okay, so seeing that...